theories have no place either in Syria or other states, emphasizing that the resistance is now much stronger in facing dangers and wars. Zionist settlers storm anew into Al-Aqsa Mosque, supported by Israeli occupation troops. Many people were killed or wounded by Takfiri elements who assaulted them on the outer of a Shia mosque in Al-Ihsa, east of Saudi Arabia. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Irado Krikorian with the news in English. Hezbollah Secretary General Hassan Nasrallah has said that the main objective of the Takfiri project in the region is to impose hegemony on Syria, the axis of the resistance. During a ceremony commemorating the 10th of the month of Muharram in the southern suburb of Beirut, Nasrallah said, "The Takfiri's project has no future and no life anywhere." He affirmed that the resistance today is much stronger in confronting all dangers and wars. "We must be highly confident in it and reassured about it," he added. "Anyone who believes that the events in Syria have had their impact on the strength of the resistance and have distracted its attention away from occupied Palestine is completely delusional." Nasrallah said the Israeli threats against Lebanon are a proof of fear, pointing out that the news media, which talk about the weakness of the resistance, are merely waging psychological war, and the Israelis know the real data, which they have been collecting. "I'm telling them now that there will be no place across occupied Palestine that is out of the reach of the resistance missiles." Nasrallah said the Zionists are taking advantage of the weakness of the Islamic world in order to realize their dream. He warned of the danger now threatening Al-Aqsa Mosque and the Muslims' responsibility to defend it. Zionist settlers have stormed anew into the holy Al-Aqsa Mosque, supported by Israeli occupation troops. The Zionist gangs threaten to break into the holy shrine once again tomorrow. A state of alert has been called for by the Palestinian inhabitants of Jerusalem to confront this dangerous assault. On the other hand, and out of solid keenness to defend the sanctities, scores of the inhabitants of the holy city perform the dawn prayers in the streets and roads adjacent to the mosque's gates after they had been denied access into it by the Israeli occupiers. Syrian Arab army units have combed several villages in Al-Hasaka countryside, restoring security to the area, particularly Tal Abyad Road between Al-Hasaka and Al-Raqqa, which had been under the control of the armed terrorist groups who used to target passengers and perpetrate their criminal terrorist acts there. With the Syrian Arab army taking control of it, the southern part of Al-Hasaka city has now become fully secured. The Syrian Arab army is meanwhile continuing its advance towards Abdulaziz Mountain, the main stronghold of the Islamic State's terrorists. As part of fighting terrorism, the Australian authorities suspended the passports of 73 Australians who were about to travel to Syria to fight alongside the terrorists. Australian Attorney General George Brantis said that the authorities have been watching the movements of the terrorists before having their passports suspended. Brantis said that new measures will be taken because those people threaten the security of Australia. Brantis disclosed that 71 Australians have been fighting alongside the terrorist organizations in Syria and Iraq. 15 of them were killed, while the others are still committing terrorist acts. For his part, Australian Prime Minister Tony Abbott defended the Australian government's tight security measures by cancelling the passports of so many suspected Australian Islamic extremists who pose a risk of committing terrorist attacks even inside Australia.
Now, the best way to deal with returning foreign fighters is to stop them leaving in the first place. That's the best way to deal with them. It's to stop them leaving in the first place. And I'm able to inform the House that some 70 Australian passports have been cancelled to stop terrorists or potential terrorists from travelling. Two reasons for cancelling passports. It's to protect other countries who shouldn't have to host Australians intent on mayhem. And it's to protect us, Madam Speaker, because Australians do have a right to come back to this country, and the last thing we should want is people on our streets who have been radicalised and brutalised by participation in terrorist activities overseas.
Welcome back. The Libyan army has killed scores of terrorists and detained many others in different parts of the city of Benghazi. A military source said the Libyan army imposed control over 90% of the city within its military campaign to crush the terrorists of the so-called Ansar al-Sharia and the Shura Council of the Revolutionists of Benghazi. In Tripoli, Libyan army units were about to impose complete control over the city after killing a big number of the terrorists of the so-called Fajr Libya in Kikle city. Finally, five people were killed and nine others injured when three masked men shot at them in Al-Dalwa village in Al-Ihsa province. Locals said the attack took place as worshippers were leaving a religious complex after taking part in the ceremonies of Ashura religious festivity. The shooting comes as the eastern part of Saudi Arabia has been witnessing continuous demonstrations following the issuance of the verdict to execute the religious scholar Namr al-Namr within fierce security campaigns launched by the Saudi authorities to crush the peaceful activities the country has been witnessing since 2011. With this, we conclude our news for today. Thank you for watching. For more details about Syria and the region and to view this bulletin again, you can always visit our website in English, syriaonline.sy. Now to latest business and market news with Nariman Qassam, but after a short break.